My name's Amanda and welcome to Lunar Elements. This is for the Moon in Leo transit between the 17th of May and the 20th of May. And this is for air signs, so Gemini, Libra and Aquarius. So throughout this transit, we're going to see the Moon quincunx Jupiter as well as trine Neptune and oppose Pluto. It's also we are going to see Uranus semi-sextile Chiron, and we also are going to see the Moon trining Chiron on the 18th and 19th of this Moon transit. So the semi-square to Mercury that it will be making on the 18th, I feel if anything is gonna, it's giving me an open door energy. Like, so throughout this transit, with also the sextile to Mercury and Venus that we'll see toward the tail end, and also the opposition to Jupiter and Pluto, Jupiter and Saturn, that's right, because we're going to see a quincunx to Neptune, yeah, that's right. So, and then a semi-square to Mars on the tail end of this transit too, okay? So throughout this transit, it's a really, really good idea to just go with the flow of the energies as they arise. So what I'm feeling is there's going to be the sort of like highlights of this for you, whether you're watching your sun, moon or rising, or your progressed sun, moon and rising right now. Like, please go and check out those other signs for yourself as well for more messages. However, what I'm feeling is like each time there's like a spike in the energy, so to speak. If you were thinking of the Schumann resonance, like every time that the energy spikes really high, it tends to force us into a shadow aspect to a degree, you know. No matter how high our vibration already is, we feel that to a degree. So, and what I'm feeling is it's like thank you so much. They're just saying it's like having a prickle in your sock, or having like just like this little spike come in, and it's like a little itch you can't scratch, but it's more of a like a thistle in your sock or something. So let's get into it. I feel, are there any other messages collectively there? Yeah, they're going to say for many of you air signs, this opposition to Saturn should really be taken into consideration. So check to see where Saturn is in your natal chart as well as to where Leo is in your natal or progress charts for sun, moon and rising, okay? Because then you'll get a better idea of the housing situation, houses for yourself, of where this is going to show up in your life and how it will affect your present reality, okay? So let's get into it. Gemini, this is hitting off in your third house, which is your house, ruled by Mercury. All right, what messages do we have for Gemini, please? First card out, the Eight of Wands. Beautiful manifesting energy there. This next card wanted to come out too is the Wheel of Fortune. What other card do we have, please, for Gemini? The Four of Wands, which I was just speaking about housing as well in the introduction there. So you might want to go back and listen to that. And underlying energies, the High Priestess. Thank you so much. They've just said, for those of you who are psychics, energy practitioners, workers, light workers who are watching this, I feel with this moon transiting your third house, the claircognizance is going to be next level is what they're saying, okay? So with the Eight of Wands into the Wheel of Fortune and the Four of Wands, I can't ignore the fact that I really believe that you've either manifested a new home, perhaps you've manifested a new home or a union, okay? Because in the Four of Wands here, this couple have just gotten married and moved into their castle, all right? So Eight of Wands into the Wheel of Fortune, very much that energy of fast things coming in, but all in divine timing with the Wheel of Fortune, because it does remind us that change is our only constant, you know, and energy is always in flux, you know, like that's just the way the universe is. So what other messages, please, do you have for Gemini for this spread? They're talking to me about a business opportunity right now, Gemini. So Gemini, if you've been waiting on receiving messages back with regards to setting up foundations in a business capacity here with the Four of Wands, right? What action steps do you need to take? Or do you need to follow up on an email? Are you meant to be replying to an email at this point in time and you're like unsure of how to approach it? They're just telling me that you've been looking over terms and conditions. So if that's in for a sale of a property as well, I feel that using your intuition at this time and feeling into it, underlying energy of the High Priestess is the Ace of Wands and the Ten of Pentacles. I feel that it's going to be, thank you. They're just saying it will be a solid new foundation for you. Once you've replied or received the reply that you're waiting on. What other messages, please, do you have for Gemini? They're saying clarifier already, guys. Clarify, please, for this spread. Okay, so it's flown out onto the floor over there. Underlying message is Seven of Swords, so just bear with me one moment, excuse me. It's the Justice card. Thank you. Yeah, thank you. They're just saying, fair trade is the phrase they're giving to me right now, fair trade. So considering that the Seven of Swords underlying message with the Five of Wands and the Three of Cups, with the Justice clarifying this spread, is I feel that, yeah, okay, the reconciliation of differences, okay, with the Five of Wands here, this is often, and the Seven of Swords, you know, this is often very much a energy of people can't get it together. You know, they can't find an equal ground or an equal footing. So if this is the case, look to the Justice card, because it's one of the three cards that have an upright sword in the tarot, which means absolute clarity. And this is the card for Libra as well. So check to see where Libra is in your chart, Venus, what's going on right now with those planets in your natal and your progressed, okay? I really don't like, I'm not getting a good vibe from this Seven of Swords and Five of Wands energy, even though we do have the Three of Cups underneath that. So I do feel that an amicable is the word they're giving me right now. An amicable resolution will be made here, because the first phrase that came out with this Justice card was fair trade, you know, so are you doing an energy exchange with people, or are you actually in a business agreement right now and trying to work out the terms and conditions, as they mentioned earlier? What advice do you have for Gemini on this? There's just saying to, when the moon sextiles Mercury and Venus, this will be happening around the 19th. Afternoon of the 19th into the 20th, I believe, once the moon is finalizing its transit through Leo. Yeah, so wait until the 19th. Make sure you have all the information as well, Gemini. Thank you so much. They're just reminding me, like, the North Node is in your sign right now. So how is this affecting your natal chart and your progressions, you know? Like, what degrees your sun, moon, or rising out, or your progressed sun, moon, or rising out in Gemini, you know, and check to see where the North Node is in that. Because I feel, okay, North Node was conjunct Mercury not too long ago. So I feel the North Node is around the 17 to 18 degree mark. I don't believe it's entered the first decan of Gemini yet. They are showing me 10, so it may have just entered. Please go and check that to see where the North Node in Gemini, because that's the return of 19 year cycle, okay? To see how that's hitting off on your natal positions and of Sun, Moon, or Rising and your progressions, okay? Are there any other messages, please, for Gemini on this? Yeah, I got a no straight away. Okay. So Gemini, thank you so much for being here. I'm going to leave that there. Please like, share, and subscribe, and check the description box on how you can work with me one-on-one. And I'll catch you on the next video. Bye. All right, so next up is Libra. Libra. What messages do we have for Libra? On the timer, the Six of Cups coming out straight away for you, Libra. So this second chance at soul, like a soul purpose is what I'm feeling straight away for you. And this is hitting off in your 11th house as well. So what soul family or soulmates have you been connecting with lately, Libra, that really are helping you with this renewal of your energy, you know, like being, it's going through the 11th house, this transit. Yeah, they're focusing me on the 19th for you when the moon will sextile Mercury and Venus, you know, and it's going to oppose Jupiter and Saturn as well. I'm feeling positive energies there for you as well with the oppositions, because I feel that it's going to really confirm or clarify for you. Clarify is the first word. Clarify for you what your soul's purpose path is. And if you look up the number 1155, that angel number is so powerful for me. It has been since the very beginning of my journey. So after quitting the corporate world with the law firm, I downgraded and went into a trust account manager's position at an insurance firm. The day I gave my day I sat down with my manager and told him that I want to leave, which was May of 2017, I looked at my clock and it was 11:55. So please go and check out that angel number, because you've just had the Hanged Man reversed. So this waiting energy, Libra, to go ahead and do the things, I feel is over. Like you're just so ready to embrace it. This is also big. Yeah, I'm just getting chills. Thank you so much. Odin's just come in. Yeah. Odin is such a powerful guide for me. And he's just here right now, Libra, to remind you that, yeah, thank you. Can you repeat that for me, please, though? You're not just here to heal yourself. However, you are the priority. And this is why I feel this Hangman in reverse is granting you a permission slip to move forward. You know, like you're not remaining stuck or stagnant in that energy of, oh, I've got to stay back and do the things. So if you didn't check out yet, and you got the Seven of Wands right now as well. So that's always an encouragement to move forward despite any perceived challenges or obstacles, you know. And last card, please, for Libra, the Knight of Wands. So now it's time to have fun. As we saw with the Six of Cups coming out at the start and this hitting off in your 11th, like go and have fun with those whom are soul family and those whom you love. And thank you so much. They've just said to just put the baggage down, Okay, so like one of the techniques I speak my clients through and guide my clients through, right, is stepping into the quantum reality and seeing and visiting with aspects of self that are carrying outdated archaic belief systems and paradigms, and allowing them to actually bundle them up in a sack or a suitcase and actually place them down, and with grace and graciousness in their heart to say thank you for all of the lessons, thank you for all of the growth, thank you for everything that you gave to me. However, you're no longer required to where I am going, so thank you, and I'm going to leave you here. You know, this is such a powerful reading, I feel, for you, Libra, because it's like you've needed that permission slip, you know? And the Death card is the underlying energy of these three cards as well. So you have been getting guided to just surrender into what it is that your heart wants, what it is that you know that is going to make you feel fulfilled within. And then this energy of, you know, healing yourself and healing others will just come more naturally, because you'll be serving from a state of overflow. And that's the only place in which we can serve, is from our overflow. You know, you can't pour from an empty cup, right? So clarify, all right? Yeah. Yeah, the Four of Cups. Want to clarify this, because this is not really, it's giving me very different vibes to what this reading was about. Oh, okay. Yeah, thank you. Okay, I've just picked up the message. Okay, so it is, it's a beautiful clarifier for what I just said, because they are drawing me to the cups here. And as I was just speaking about, it's about following what's going to really fill your heart up, you know, and spirit's gifting it to you, you know. So it's just being about being open to receiving that. And thank you, my heart just started to ache a little right now as well. So open up your heart to receive the limitless possibilities that, you know, yeah, you know, my sternum is aching, something chronic right now, reading for you, Libra. Like, allow yourself to be in this jovial, like light-hearted teenager energy, okay? And really embrace the gifts of that the divine have been attempting to drop into your reality. Because with the Four of Wands as the underlying energies here, this is a beautiful time for celebration of that, okay? Of all you've achieved, all you've created in your life, you know? And I feel there's this massive need for honoring the heart space right now, considering how much my sternum actually, like, it feels like I've got a clamp on it, Libra, you know? And you love to love. So how about it's now time to show yourself all of that love that you so freely bestow upon others, you know? So Libra, I'm going to leave it there. Thank you so much for tuning in. Please like, share, and subscribe. Check the description box on how you can work with me one-on-one. And also hit the notification bell, because I have a really divinely beautiful announcement coming up at the end of this week. And yeah, I'll catch you on the next video. All right, so next up is Aquarius. Aquarius, first card off the rank is Ace of Pentacles. This is, of course, hitting off in your seventh house of Libra and thus Venus. I nearly said Virgo. So Aquarius, how does Virgo relate to you? This is for Aquarius Sun, Moon, or Rising, Progressed Sun, Moon, or Rising. What messages, please, do we have for the Aquarius Collective for this Moon in Leo transit? Whoa, okay. Four cards just came out. Two are face up, which is the King of Pentacles and the Hermit card, and I was just speaking about Virgo energy, right, Aquarius? And then the two that are face down. Oh, beautiful. The Eight of Pentacles and the Three of Wands. Aquarius. This is, wow. You have been, thank you. Yeah, they're just saying you have been building some very, very solid foundations here with the King of Pentacles. The Eight of Pentacles implies all of the work that you've been doing. And I feel that a lot of it has to do with your health as well, is what I'm picking up on with the Virgo card of the Hermit here, okay? It's like been really acknowledging that being the alchemist of your own reality, it's like, well, the only way I can change my external reality is by changing my internal reality. So it's like you've been really working hard as well on creating this brand new abundant beginning coming in for you. You know, you've made the decision in the Two of Wands, and now in the Three of Wands, you're like, all right, beautiful, like, let's bring it on, you know? And that's what this Three of Wands is giving me. It's like a really, like, thank you. Triumphant is the word they're giving me energy. It's like, yes, I fucking did the thing, you know? I love that energy for you. So, I feel lightheaded because of it, Aquarius. So, that's so amazing. Thank you. They're just telling me right now. Thank you so much. My guides are just telling me right now that it's been a long time coming for you. Like, it's like something that you've never given up on giving up on. You've never given up on giving. That's really interesting, Aquarius. I would really love it if you could drop in the comments what that is. Because this is relating to health, perhaps it's like more an addictions or, you know, a lifestyle change that you've been working so hard on and creating these brand new solid foundations. However, Aquarius, because the Hermit card is here, I am going to go back to, please go and check your chart to see where Virgo is in your chart, okay? To see which house it is in, because Virgo rules the sixth house, which is all about day-to-day work and health. They are the healer. The Virgos are the healers of the zodiac, you know? So, what other messages, please, do we have for Aquarius? They're showing me musical instruments. I'm seeing a keyboard right now, like a piano. And there's a trumpet there as well. Yeah, so if you love music and you've been playing music, I really feel that this is gonna help you, not just with your healing, right? Because we are all energy, and sound is one of the most beautiful healers, okay? Like, I personally love crystal singing bowls, solfeggio tunes, binaural beats, things like that. Like, really utilize the sound healing aspect of things. And I feel with the trumpet there as well, like, it doesn't look like a normal trumpet with the three keys. It looks more like it's the circular trumpet, so like, I think, is it a bugle? So it's like, yes, I have arrived, like, you know. I just feel like, because when do they sound the bugle? It's at the lead of a charge, right? At the beginning of leading a charge into battle, or after victory even. I can't recall which one it is. So, but this is the energies it's giving me right now. It's just like, dun dun dun, like, I'm here, I'm ready to do all the things, let's go, you know. Thank you. Revolutionary energy has been coming up for every read so far for this Leo moon transit, and I'm not surprised, because Leo is ruled by the sun and is a really massive-hearted zodiac sign, you know, it rules the heart. So I feel that with this energy for you, Aquarius, I just feel like I can't get this smile off my face for one. So whatever it is, I would love to hear it in the comments of what you've been so successful at working toward, because with the Three of Wands here as well, I feel like this brand new door opening for you right now is what I'm feeling for you, Aquarius. They are reminding me as well of the trines to Chiron that this will be making. So you might find over this moon in Leo transit that you're gonna have spikes of energy which will come back in. And if this has been like a new pattern in your health that you've taken on, I really feel that that's going to be tested over this time, especially when the moon opposes Jupiter and Saturn, because you'll need to, an oppositioning requires you to balance out those energies, okay? So yes, can be a difficult aspect, but the whole idea of an opposition is balancing out that lunar energy, okay? In the opposition to Jupiter and Saturn, you've got to, thank you so much. They're just giving me an analogy come through. Thank you. All right, so what I'm feeling is, thank you. What I'm receiving is you have to balance out and find somewhere along the polarity, which is Hermetics 101, right? Like we polarize between like cold and heat, for example. We polarize somewhere nice and neutral in the middle, so that it's not just comfortable, but it's conducive to where we're going. I feel when the moon opposes Jupiter and Saturn for you, what's going to be required is for you to successfully traverse this, is to blend the moon, Leo moon energy, with the Piscean Jupiter energy and the Aquarian Saturnian energy, all right? Because it's just telling me brand new horizons, all right? Brand new horizons. And they're telling me to hold fast. They're telling me to tell you, hold fast to what it is that your moon aspect wants, okay? Because if you blend all of these energies in together in this opposition, I really feel you are going to hold that value to yourself, hold fast to that value of yourself and of what your heart and soul desires. And then you will be able to expand into this new beginning with, yeah, I'm just getting chills right now on my right-hand side. With the Saturn in Aquarius and Jupiter in Pisces energies, okay? Yeah. Yeah, beautiful. Yeah, they're just telling me with the Saturn in Aquarius energy, as you have been trying so goddamn hard to make this change in your life, so don't fuck it up now. Because this is what the opposition is going to test you on. And this is happening on the 19th of May, okay? Through till, oh, I feel like just before it closes out its moon transit in Leo. So Aquarius, I hope that that really resonates for you, because it felt like such a beautiful read. Underlying messages, Three of Cups. So it's time to celebrate. Celebrate you though, okay? Like, yeah, time to celebrate you 100%, because the self-sabotaging stuff that you've worked so hard to leave behind, now with this moon transit, it's not time to fall off the wagon, so to speak, for lack of a better term, you know? Yeah, hold fast, okay? I hope that resonates. I look forward to hearing the comments, and thank you so much for being here. Please like, share, and subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next video. Oh, and the description box below has all the links on how you can connect with me and work with me one-on-one. All right. Thank you all so much for being here. Have a beautiful day. 19 above, love always. Bye.